I got one level rancher here, built 1976. Assessment value $850, but obviously it's probably out on this one. I would just say maybe 1.1, just be safe. It's got metal siding, pretty original house. Put a bar in there or something. I'm gonna go for the inside here. So the living room here. I think it's a 3-bedroom. It's got the old flooring here. Most likely asbestos for sure. Flooring. We have another bedroom here. Same kind of flooring. So most likely all the drywall and all the flooring will be asbestos here. Textured ceilings. Another floor here. Pretty basic house. Probably the furnace area. Must be back here somewhere. See, here's the garage. It's got drywall. It's all wood. It's like wood. It might be drywall. Yeah, I think it's drywall. It's probably a gym area, I would think, or something. So pretty basic house, not much here. Area. Okay, that's it for this tour. Not very much here. Probably like more like 1.1 million, I would think. Okay, we'll see. Thought my buddy was joking. So there's some Kenwoods up here. Look how cheap that eaves are there. They just put the metal siding, no sheeting or nothing. Crazy. Some stereo stuff here. It's all Kenwood, but e-waste is e-waste in my eyes. Got the remote control too. Okay, I'm gonna go grab this stuff here. Anything else stashed up here? It's weird how they throw it up here like that. Nothing else up there. This amp looks okay. It's actually really heavy. It's kind of with a power amp. Okay, let me just bag this up here. Okay. I'm greeted by a black rabbit. Look at that. You don't see black rabbits too often. Hey, Michael, check the rabbit out.
Hey?
Check the rabbit, look that way. But don't scare him.
Where is he?
By your car. Go around your car. He's not too scared.
He's friendly. He's a puppy.
I think he is. Black is, you don't see black too often. He's not a wild one. Oh, there he's running. Awfully late. Let's see if he's still there. Everything. Yeah, this is a cheap one. Got a couple mortars on there, but very cheap. Got a mortar here, here, and here. Okay, I see a barrel on the side of the road here I'm gonna grab. I'm gonna move this stuff over here. Muddy. in, which is good. Okay, well, barrel's gonna come in handy. I can put heavy metals in there. Maybe sealed units and whatever. Round up. Okay. Okay, I came here and the little black cat was sleeping in the car, but second time I've seen him sleeping there, so we tried to get him some food, but anyways, took off. So I'm gonna put some metal from the side here. All this loose metal here, this and that in the bin. Takes up so much room. I was gonna put this on the lower gutters, but the gutters are a different size downpipes. They're like more square, so I can't use them. I'm gonna put it down there for the water. Little cheat. This one's got rivets here. Okay, I'll show you in a second on that one. Let me get organized here. I'm gonna clean some of this up here. Stop by. Okay, so we got a few here. Probably extruded. This one will be extruded. This extruded also. It's all extruded there. So rotted, rusted. Could be a square, or could even be a Torx. Which I think it's a Torx, but let's see if we can break it off. You have to check the bottoms, because a lot of times the bottoms are, they're going to be steel. Stainless. This one you have to unscrew from here. Steel. Super tight, doesn't want to come out. Okay, so this is my dirty aluminum here. These pails here. Just can't win. Heater seems to be working, but last time it wasn't working, so I don't know. Steel. Pretty heavy. Wow. How heavy that thing is. Let's see what the weight is. Maybe like 4 pounds, 5 pounds maybe. 5.1 pounds, 5.2. 5 pounds, look at that. I love it. Okay. Those ones, I have this one here. This is would be extruded, but they keep changing their mind all the time. One says it's extruded, one says it doesn't. So since we have, okay, let me just finish starting this here. This thing here, it's a sprinkler, but it's got plastic. Hard plastic here. There. The sprinkler nozzle, spray nozzle. It's all brass. Okay. Okay, well, this one here, since we have rivets here, that's the weak point is rivets. So, see, weak points, weakest point will be the rivet. Yeah, so the cat's missing, can't find him. I don't know, maybe someone scooped him because he's a really cool looking cat. Siamese ginger. Pretty rare cats. So, daughter's really upset. Okay. Well, I was gonna keep that actually. It's like for cleaning gutters and stuff. I'll leave it here for now. Don't pay very much anyway, so it's not gonna matter. I have a lot of these paint sprayer things, extensions. There's a screw here. You can probably get it with the cast extension. Cast aluminum. It'll be extruded, I would think. I would say extruded, but. Make it a little smaller. Okay, I'm just putting an extruded pile. I mean, it's kind of got little ridges all over the place, but who knows? Not in the world. All the tripping hazards, right? plastic, I think. Yeah. Okay, old sheet. Plastic. Okay, so I think we have another container full here. Pretty heavy, probably, I don't know, 35 pounds probably. It's all clean here. Enough stainless there too. Funny how the handle's stainless. This part's something. So I'm not sure what that's gonna be, stainless or maybe cast aluminum even too. Grinder open. They're grinded, that's the only way you can tell. Stainless. We got some stainless. Espresso kind of handle. It's funny how. Yeah, just hold on, keep it for now. It's probably no good, but it's a knife. Let's leave for now. If I get blades for it or something. So systematically going through all the junk, trying to figure out what. It's weird. How could be the handle stainless but the mouth part's not stainless? How's that possible? A little more, that's stainless for sure. This is a little more steel. See? It's weird. Some screwdrivers here. Precision. Thank you. wire. Nails to keep. Okay, well, that's pretty well clean. Put brass here. The lock okay. Here should be a brass skirt around it. The rest will be pot metal. Or could be even cast aluminum, but brass is only a small sliver. Gloves are all soaking wet now. Touching all this, everything's. Well, what I'm trying to do is clean everything that's in the boxes and stuff laying around. You have to peel around like can spam. Once you get kind of half of it, there it is. There's your brass. And this is your cast. Don't cast aluminum for now. This thing is kind of like dirty. Don't admit it. It's brass and should actually come off. Sometimes they rotted out. Let me see if I can knock it off quickly. Supposed to knock the tumbler out completely, but I squeezed it pretty good, so it may not come out. Only thing I can do is put it back on here, squeeze it a little bit differently. It's gonna come this side. Probably won't go because I crimped it up a bit, but I actually could even unscrew this one. We'll try for a quick second. This is threaded, so integrated, but that's okay. Got a brass tumbler here. This is cast aluminum. Brass tumbler. This was steel. This is the coaxial here. Anyways, this one I'm gonna have to break it. Sometimes they're glued on, like pressed and glued on. I'm not seeing nothing on here. I don't see nothing. Might just put glued on. Yeah. I would say that's pot metal, if anything. Pot metal is usually shiny. I need a new container for the pot metal. Yeah, pot metal. Okay, throw this in, but it's aluminum. So, we're gonna take off. The frame is aluminum. There's quite a few parts there. I'm just gonna take this off here. So. Okay. Let's all that one dirty. You have to know how to take these bikes apart. A lot of them are not that easy. You got Preston steel on different things. This is aluminum here. I don't think it's no steel there, so it's aluminum. Big bonus already, steel. Not so heavy. This one will be dirty. Two are clean, steel, grab aluminum. Dirty. Okay, so see, I didn't have tools to take the stuff off. I can probably just sell dirty, I guess. Usually, I cut these usually, but they paid 31 cents before. I don't know what they pay now, but I'll sell dirty. I got some dirty going already. I don't have to deal with it. Just got too much other stuff to deal with. Let me get these tires processed. Cut the tires off and then I'll be done. And I have TV boards here, one box. Two boxes to deal with. Okay, you've seen this before. All I do is I take the tire off, cut the spokes, and that's it. Simple.
The one I got found today.
It's a power amplifier. It's got an amplifier, double cassette tape, tuner, five changer, CD maybe or something like that, five or six. Stereo. There's two amplifiers. It's different. Maybe two receivers, two amplifiers. I don't know, but. It's kind of interesting. Price is right. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put all the stuff here, sitting here. I have to go through and find out what I can take off.
The TV board here. This one actually has aluminum sides for some reason.
Some of it's steel, some of it's aluminum. I think that one's a really old school one, this one. I'm gonna try to salvage any good components. Or just the scrap metal. Like here. Little transformers like this. I'll take those. There's another transformer here. There's a little copper spool. See here. Transformer. Two more here. There's a few more things I'll take off. It's a green board. Okay. Green board. And on this side here, I have some more. See, stupid animals were in this thing here. Probably the squirrels. I took all those cherry pits. Just the second time I cleaned this out already. Cherry pits and were. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is separate the steel. I'll just randomly show you what I have here. The aluminum side. Then there's just circuit boards like this. TV boards. There should be like heat sinks, little transistors, ICs and stuff like that. Now this whole thing is full of cherry pits. See that? Let's throw in the garbage. So I'll process as much as I can. And I'll show you what I processed out of that one box. There's too much small stuff to show you. I'm gonna show you the bin. I'm gonna rinse that out in a second, but I'll show you the bin. I cleaned along here already, so you can see I'm starting to clean up. That's the bin right now. I got a dishwasher there, but I'm gonna put I have 2-3 appliances sitting right now that I wanna put in there, but not at the moment. Okay, I stripped all the boards, put them there. Some of the flybacks and stuff I scrapped. I just threw it in a garbage pile. I'm not sure if there's gonna be any copper in this. I see copper wires, but a lot of the stuff is just off TVs or really nothing. But anyways, this is all aluminum. These are transformers for sure. A little bit of copper spools, right there, wire. These are all the IC chips that I popped off the TV boards. Because those are going to be only for copper recovery anyways, so... You know, I'm going to experiment, grind it up and stuff, and then see what I can do. And then I got these are MOSFETs. They're for copper recovery. Some brass contacts, a little bit of wire. One other board here, which will just go into a green board. So it wasn't too bad. It's actually a spool here. Not bad, you know, for a... It didn't take too long. But, bit of a workout. I separate the plastic off the bottom. These are all going to be copper recovery things. So that's not too bad. I'm going to move on to something else. Maybe that bucket next. So eliminated one bucket completely. And it's going to go into like aluminum and then extruded. Like this is just, this stuff is extruded here. Other stuff is like old sheet. Extruded. So old sheet. Extruded. When it could be physically bent, they figure it's not going to be extruded, but sometimes it could be. The heater seems to be working. Okay,